This is the Ice Age. In North Africa, 20,000 years ago, while the northern continents are enveloped in ice, the once green Sahara is now drying out. Forced by the ever-spreading deserts, the Aterian foragers migrated to the tropics and to the coast. The peak of the last ice age is at an end. The ice sheets that covered much of northern Europe, Asia and North America, had begun to melt. One thousand years later, humans in the Shenren cave, in East Asia, made pots from clay fired at high temperatures, to give them a hard and durable form. The invention of pottery was significant. These new vessels made it easier to carry and keep food and water compared to using natural containers, like gourds, carved wood, or animal hides. And they made boiling and stewing of foods possible, leading to a more varied and nutritious diet. After 1,000 years, the hunter-gatherer population in the Caucasus region saw a rapid increase. They developed light skin that absorbs more vitamin D, becoming better suited to areas with less sunlight. Within 700 years, Australians used boomerangs as hunting weapons. Another 300 years later, the Sabellians were a semi-sedentary population living near the Nile River, who made mousteroid tool points and microblades from flint. Meanwhile, Paleo-Indians, the first peoples ever to set foot on the Americas, have now inhabited the Alaska's southeastern coast. Around the same time, descending from the Solutrians who survived the last glacial period, the Magdalenians populated Western Europe. They made denticulated microliths and progressed in arts and culture, making many pictures carved on bones, figurines, and cave paintings. Like their ancestors, they hunted reindeer, red deer, horses, and other large mammals, like the mammoths. After 1,000 years, the Trialetian Caucasian nomads, who lived south of the Caucasus Mountains, were hunting wild goats, wild boar and brown bear, and made some stone tools from obsidian. At the same time, the foragers in Japan reached a considerable degree of sedentism and made pottery with cored impressions. Not long after, glaciers that covered Canada began melting, allowing Paleo-Indians to move south and east into Canada, reaching Meadowcroft Rock Shelter. Meanwhile, Eastern Europe was repopulated by Epigravettian people from the Southeastern Europe Ice Age refuge. Around the same time, humans settled the Cactus Hill and Topper areas, and Galt in Texas. Within 500 years, Hamburg, rooted in the Magdalenian, was a culture of reindeer hunters near the ice caps in northwestern Europe. They lived in tipis, conical tents made of animal hides or pelts on wooden poles. After around 500 years, during the excessively dry Ogolian period, the number of settlements made by the Middle Stone Age West Africans decreased. Soon, the Natufians were a semi-sedentary population in Levant, on the eastern coast of the Mediterranean. They used millstones to grind grains. To carry water, they used ostrich shells as containers. The Natufians were the first to make sickle blades, used to cut wild cereals. They practiced archery and used shaft straighteners made of ground stone. They also made many bone tools, including harpoons and fishhooks. They carved a few human figurines in limestone, but their favorite subject was animals. For personal adornment, these foragers wore decorative items, such as pendants, bracelets, necklaces, earrings, and belt ornaments, worked from stone and bone. In death, these possessions accompanied them. They usually buried their dead laid on their side, in a flexed position, along with their personal items. Also, the Eastern hunter-gatherers descended from the Mesolithic nomads of Eastern Europe. At the same time, the sandbushmen around Lake Nakuru, in East Africa, made Eburran tools, like large-backed blades, crescent microliths, burins, and end scrapers. Some were made from obsidian. Not long after, the Anatolian hunter-gatherers, who diverged from Caucasus nomads, lived in central Anatolia. Meanwhile, the Qadan people, living in Nubia in the Upper Nile Valley, made efforts to water, care for, and harvest local plants. They used large numbers of grinding stones to prepare and consume wild grasses and grains. There were conflicts between the groups, with periods of invasion or intense inter-tribal war, using weapons such as spears, darts, or arrows. Five 500 years later, Paleo-Indians inhabited the caves across the Yucatan Peninsula, in southeast Mexico. Soon, these foragers settled Huaca Prida, in Peru, on the western coast of South America. In the meantime, they spread up to Monte Verde in southern Chile. Within 100 years, at Xubaica, Natufians made the first pita-like flatbread from wild cereal seeds and papyrus cousin tubers, ground into flour and spread on a flat rock placed over a fire. Bread will become an important part of the diet of many future cultures. Some 100 years later, people settled the Paisley Caves area, in western North America. Also, the Natufians settled at Ain Malaha, at the foot of the Naftali Mountains, near the ancient Lake Hula. After 300 years, an important woman was buried in a ceremonial pit in the Hilazon Tactic Cave, along with three aurochs and 86 tortoises, all of which have been brought to the site during a funeral feast. The body was surrounded by tortoise shells, the pelvis of a leopard, forearm of a boar, a wingtip of a golden eagle, and skull of a beach marten. Not long after, at Ain Malaha, the Natufians built massive round communal buildings. They cut into the slope and built retaining dry stone walls in order to support the surrounding sloping ground. Meanwhile, at the Wadi Hama base camp, the Natufians built large, durable dwellings that were maintained and revisited over many generations. Around the same time, Austroasiatic-speaking groups made Hobinian tools at many sites throughout mainland and island Southeast Asia. Soon, nomads populated Tema Tema, on the northern coast of South America. In the meanwhile, the Federmesser cultures of the northern European plain made small-backed flint blades. These Western hunter-gatherers, descending from the Mesolithic foragers of Europe, were dark-skinned, dark-haired, and blue-eyed. At the same time, as the climate improved, Mesolithic nomads extended their range into Scotland, up to Howburn Farm. Not long after, human activity in the Sahara and Arabia stopped, as climate became extremely dry, lakes and swamps dried out and rivers were stunted. Within 1,000 years, the Swiderian population in Poland, who made tang blades, migrated from the west after a 300-year-long settlement break, and moved gradually towards the east. Meanwhile, the Creswellian culture in Britain, rooted in the Magdalenian, made trapezoidal-backed blades. Around the same time, humans arrived in Arlington Springs, on the Channel Islands of California. Soon, the Ust-Karenga culture made ceramics in southern East Siberia. After 100 years, temperatures dropped drastically during the Younger Dryas, which was the most severe and longest-lasting of several interruptions to the warming of the Earth's climate. It produced a sudden drought in the Levant, and endangered the wild cereals, which could no longer compete with dryland scrub. This affected the foragers who had become dependent on the wild grains to sustain a relatively large sedentary population. By clearing scrub and planting seeds, the Natufians were the first people to practice agriculture. At Abu Huraira, in the upper Euphrates Valley, they cultivated rye and used substantial amounts of plant. They were also the first to brew beer in the Rikafet Cave on Mount Carmel. Natufians started to build smaller domestic residential structures, 5 to 7 meters in diameter, as at Ain Malaha. These structures were less meticulously planned and executed, lacking the complex arrays of postholes and footings. Around the same time, as part of the mass extinction of megafauna in northern Eurasia in the Americas, most mammoths died out during the last glacial retreat. Soon, this forced the Ahrensburgian nomadic hunters in north-central Europe to exploit other forms of subsistence, like reindeers and maritime resources. Within 400 years, the Azilians in the Franco-Cantabrian region made microliths with rounded retouched backs, crude flat bone harpoons and pebbles with abstract decoration. After another 300 years, the return to glacial climate conditions however would last for over a millennium, leading to a decline in Natufian permanent settlements in the Levant, and a reversion to a more mobile way of life. It forced most of the Abu Huraira inhabitants to move 50 kilometers to the northeast, on the other side of the Euphrates. They settled at Maribet. There, they used hearths, cooking pits and querns, and cultivated rye and barley. Agriculture led to the rise of sedentary human civilization. Farming created food surpluses that enabled people to live in large settlements. The Neolithic Age has arrived. Thank you for traveling back in time with us on this historical journey. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, leave a comment and select all notifications for more videos like this one. Until next time, keep exploring the past to understand the present, and even foresee the future.